finishing up the Girls Frontline event before, well, before it's over in a few hours, actually. Let's go ahead and use the actual music from the game this time. See what happens. Iceland, welcome back. For a moment there, I thought you were just gonna stay in Tati's stream instead. I don't mind that you bug me a lot. Honestly, I could be used to bugging. Nice. I too am also watching Tati stream on my phone while also streaming everything here. I just need to go ahead, now that I have the proper stuff, I'm going to go ahead and finish this last mission, and then I'm going to read all of the cutscenes for this game. Yeah, she's very high energy, like holy fuck, we're like polar opposites in that regard. Not that that's a problem. Yeah, I know what you mean. Her enthusiasm is infectious, but I don't find them annoying, unlike some streamers for some reason. I don't know what the difference is. Alright, let's try. I'm gonna be using a guide to cheese. Well, not really cheese, but to beat this. To beat this, whatchamacallit. Deploy a scarecrow in the command post. Ensure she has phantom step. Move her up 2 nodes, right 1 node, and up 1 node in your turn. Okay. So, had any thoughts so far on what you want your VTuber to be like? I believe you mentioned wanting to become a VTuber yourself at one point. At some point. Oh, you do? Let me guess, are you basing her off of Millie Thompson? Oh. Sorry. That was probably a bad assumption on my part. If you say so. Okay. Turn two. Swap with Scarecrow's dummy again and move to the right two node. Do not open the box yet. Wait. Oh, I'm done. Okay. I almost screwed up. Switch. To the right, to the right. All your shit in the box to the right. Deploy a combat echelon on the command post. They will need to fight heavy armor. End your turn. An anti-armor squad, huh? I think I have just the thing for that. This should do. Do your worst. What the fuck? Got to kick this baby, these people out really quick. Give me your pistols. And look, it's Jill. I need to have her cook up a concoction that will help this team flourish. Let's use... Bleeding Jane. Which, and the Bleeding Jane is... Bronson, Paradetta, and Flannerguide. Did I get that right? Let me see here. Bronson, Paradelta, and Flannery Guide. Okay, cool. I need to give those guys better exoskeletal suits. Make sure that they're assembled properly. Cool. Deploy them. Okay. Leave that on. End your turn. We're on turn three now. Open the box that Scarecrow is standing on. Move Scarecrow to the right two nodes, down one node, and to the right one more node. Do not open the box. Okay, so to the right two nodes. Down one node. And to the right one more node. Do not open the box. While the enemy above may be concerning, it will move to the left and not down to attack Scarecrow. Alright, if you say so. I hope my squad's able to defeat that heavy armor that they're talking about, or I'm gonna be pissed. Oh shit, that's the heavy armor they're talking about. God damn it. Well, they might be okay. Good thing I have shields up the ass. Huh, we survived. Cool. Jill is way up. Mm-hmm. Indeed. Indeed. Okay, open the final box and you finish the map. Cool. What's in the box? Is everyone here deaf or something? What the hell is a handshake ticket? So Minos is trying to catch up with us, but thankfully we're many steps ahead of her at this time. We're going to go this way. And we're going to open the last box where we will find, hopefully, Jianxinshan. There she is. Oh shit. Cowgirl. The first model you had made, it's soy calf and simple bows, just a test. Where are you putting the model? Why was your message censored just now? RIP. Links probably are censored. Go ahead and just send it to me on Discord, I guess, since Twitch is being dumb. Oh, YouTube. Is that a cat? How cute. Yeah, I don't know why YouTube links would be censored of all things. That's like the last thing to censor, right? What program is this? Is this Live 2D? Is this Cubism? Alright, I'll leave the volume as is then. Okay, I have 60 tokens left. I can't purchase the last fairy, but I got one of them, so I'll just get these instead. Nice. Kinda sad I only got managed to get one of these fairies, but shit happens. This event will come back eventually anyway. And now then, I have to go back through all of the cutscenes and actually read them, so I get the full gist of the story. Thankfully I read pretty fast, and I don't think this should be too long of an event, but you never know. If we get this done fast enough, I might have to find something else to do. I'm gonna go ahead and have this one do a long-term launch. What? I mean, Girls Frontline is one of the few gacha games that has a decent story. It's honestly more visual novel than it is game sometimes. The events are hit or miss, but the writing is typically pretty good for them too. And of course there's the Valhalla collab, which had some of the best writing that's ever been in Girls Frontline. Like at all. Alright, how do I read the story again? Oh, start with chapter 1. See, what you're describing is actually Azure Lane, I believe. Azure Lane does not give any fucks. Oh yeah, no kidding, the Valhalla collab is great. What? This is really dark. Is this really what the manga is like? Wow. By the time Jianxing-chan lunges, Tangan-chan has already vanished. You won't get away so easily next time! Ahem. Hi, everyone! It's been a while. Do you still remember me? No? No, here we are. That's right, I'm the most popular high-tier demon from hell, Jiaxin-chan. And now I officially declare Jiaxin-chan's front lines on air. Woohoo. Jesus Christ! Oh no. Ha does she even know what a Lamia is? Lamiroid models. Come on, cry and gather me into your embrace and hand over your credit cards. Oh my god, this is too much. Oh man, this game is too much. I feel like Yuuzhan just makes collabs whatever he's interested in at the time, and one day it happened to be this manga. Oh, I'm not sure if you play Girls Frontline, but Ouroboros was originally a villain in this game. But they pretty much, after a lot of stuff and a lot of plot and a lot of backstory, they pretty much work for your PMC now. It's probably because they don't have the wireless internet that they have in their own world, because this doesn't take place in the far apocalyptic future. Yep, we're back in the 21st century. Of course, in Girls Frontline, it only takes place in the 2070s. While this one, I'm assuming, takes place in modern day or something? Something like that. Her acting skills are too strong. What the hell's a Dogeza? Oh no. She makes a good point, actually. P90 refers to Commander as honey. Also, Ouroboros has always been pretty sadistic. Let me know if I'm going too fast, by the way. I tend to read really fast so I can get these things done before the deadline, but if you want to me to slow down a little bit so you can read along too, that's fine. We meet at last, little snake. I guess CZ must be the squad leader in this case. Chanshan Chan is going to try and dropkick her way to victory. Okay, so that was the first episode. Man, there's actually shit. Am I gonna be able to read all these cutscenes before the end? Well, I guess we'll just do our best. What? Yeah! Shit. Speed. I kind of want to read this manga now. Oh wow, they actually took that from the anime. Nice. Uh-oh. Onward to chapter 2. Stay tuned for more Junction Chan's Frontline.
Shinchan drop kick!
He played us like a damn. I like how they translated this game. Zoom to fuck in on your model's tie? Sure, I could do it right now. I wish there was a way I could actually, like, grab my model and... This is movement range, this is movement smoothing, but I don't think I have an option here for cameras, but let me see. Oh! Yeah, in OBS I can do that just fine. Ta-da! Oh, shit. Wrong button. Are you feeling it now, Miss Krabs? Yeah, it's played. I think this is a stock tie as well. I didn't make this tie. Whoa. No problem. You know what? When you zoom in, it looks a lot better than it originally did in Vroid. Actually, I need to fix this now. Fuck. I'm too big. How do I into... Here we go. Anytime, Iceland. Anytime. And now back to our originally scheduled program. Literally. What did I miss here? Oh my god, what's gonna happen next? What the fuck? Eh, I can't believe Junshin Chan is dead. She really does torture her. I love how no one cares about Junshin Chan. What the f- She just teleports. Mm-hmm. Aw, it's a baby ice demon. Oh my god. What the fuck was that? I think I like Jormungandr. Don't mind my arms going crazy. I'm just taking screenshots. Except I forgot which one of these things is. Control Shift S? Okay. damn. Wow. There you go. Grimoire Volume 2. Hiding in the Dragon Bookstore this whole time. Sounds like someone's dying in the other stream. Oh my God. Too bad we couldn't get this character as a doll. Bullshit. Oh my God. Oh no. Uh-oh. They need to pay for the ice. Really? Is that a JoJo reference? Oh my god, they did not just do that. They did not just do that. That's terrible. But they did. Is that a... That's horrible. I can't believe they actually put a JoJo reference in this game. Uh-oh. That's a lot of shit to read. Oh my god. That was only chapter 2. Onwards to chapter 3. Do I have hiccups now? This is bad timing. This is really bad timing. Yeah, I know, right? I mean, all the recent events have been like this. They have been, what, 90% cutscenes and reading, and 10% actual gameplay? Which is not bad, you know. I mean, Arknights is actually like this too, where it's more cutscenes than it is gameplay, but... This is the Girls Frontline Chibi anime series is a real thing too, so this was a cross promotion just now. Actually, I'll be right back. I need to do something really quick. One moment, please. My avatar broke again. Reload VC face. That happens from time to time. And we are back. Sorry for the wait. Ta-da! Now where was I? All right. Oops, gotta turn that off too. No idea what this thing is. in hell. There we go. Welcome back. Medusa is adorable. Remember to bring money. Is she just taking several trains down to wherever she is? No way! Tsuchinokos. my god. Man, Joshin Chan is a bitch. Oh. Onwards to chapter 4. I got 2 hours and 23 minutes to finish reading the rest of this. It's gonna be close. Unfortunately. That's how it is sometimes, though. Hell yeah, best girl. P90 is surprisingly quite good at her job. Mm-hmm. Muggles. These are really smart androids, aren't they? I guess Johnson Chan is sort of like a sociopath, something approaching that. Oops. Oh. Thank you. serious business. That was chapter 4. How much time do we have left? It's 11:24 here. I got 2 hours. Well, more or less. Whoa. Oh, she's an angel. That's interesting. That was chapter 5. We're making good progress. Get to chapter 6. We got only a couple chapters left. Oh no. I'm actually getting tired reading all this shit. It's a good thing we're nearing the end, because it's getting late here. Oh no! Oops. And they've been teleported into Griffin. Yeah. And yet, I'm rushing to finish reading all these before the server resets. Oh. Jesus. Life goals right there. You know, for a slice of life manga, this is pretty serious. My eyes are starting to get heavy. This is true. Pretty much all the dolls are quirky in some form. That's a beautiful image, isn't it? Just making sure that I'm actually saving these things properly. Otherwise, I'm gonna be really upset if I manage to not save any of these screenshots. Looks like I did, though. Good. Make a nice new desktop picture. Yes or no, not everyone saves these things. A lot of my desktop backgrounds are actually taken directly from Arknight screenshots and Girls Frontline screenshots. Oh? I didn't know that. I'll just see if they have HQ versions of some of the stuff I screenshotted then. Aww. Yeah, no kidding. And now she has a minigun. Shit, man. How in chapter 6? And there's two of them here. Oh, that's beautiful. That's a beautiful desktop picture right there. Oh. Okay, onwards to chapter 7, and this is the second to last chapter. Oh my god, there's a lot of reading here too. Shit. try some cool images in this one too. What the fuck is happening? Oh, this is the base that you actually originally killed Ouroboros in one of the earlier events. Ouroboros. All of her friends are dead. Well, most of them anyway. All your base are belong to us. To give you some background, Ouroboros was kind of like the black sheep of all these girls. So, she's probably imagining herself as being a person worthy of respect. Especially Dreamer here. Dreamer is a huge bitch. She manipulates and uses everyone. In fact, part of the reason why Ouroboros was one of the few dolls to actually die was because Dreamer intentionally set her up so that she couldn't escape, and that so she would get cornered by Squad 404 and your forces. In fact, the only reason why Ouroboros is even here right now is because even though her body was annihilated, they decided to save a copy of her AI so that she's technically still alive. Oh man, you have no idea. The Girls Frontline lore is actually extremely depressing. Yeah. Uh-oh. Who could it be? Aw. Yeah, I get that feeling. My dad, to this very day, doesn't understand why anyone would enjoy a video game, because he equates video gaming with, like, effort, and effort to him is not relaxing. I'm not sure how my parents would react to VTubing either, to be honest. Oh, that's what you meant. Oh, she did? That's amazing. I'm kind of jealous. I mean, isn't that basically just acting? I'd be kind of afraid to explain my VTubing hobby to my parents because, not for the VTubing itself, but for the fact that I'm using a female androgynous character that doesn't look anything like I do in the real world. But I could probably, dispel some of that, or at least distract some of the uncomfortable things I would have to speak with them about by pointing out that the side gig of what is essentially running a show, a TV show online, is making me rich. It's like a gross oversimplification, but at least for my parents, that's the sort of explanation that I feel would work for them. Your mileage may vary. Oh my god. I do worry sometimes about gaining fame. To me, it'd be like winning the lottery. And winning lottery is kind of scary because it completely radically changes your life. But I don't know. I feel like if the good luck from the fame can be leveraged in the proper way, it wouldn't be that bad. I have a whole plan set out for if I were to win the lottery personally. Yeah, it does. I would almost say that it ruins more people's lives than it actually improves. The smart ones are the ones you don't hear about because they don't get in the news for doing a lot of stupid shit. But so many people become depressed, become bankrupt because they spend all their money, commit suicide, lose all their friends and family, become paranoid because everyone is just asking them to give them money and then doesn't talk to them ever again. All kinds of stupid shit. The hell is Venomous Descent? One of the first things you want to do when you win the lottery is to get a CSA. That's true. Man, this is a collab with a slice of life joke manga, and it still manages to add a layer of depression to it. This is kind of similar to why 40 saved 45, huh? What do you miss? Oh, yeah. I kind of missed that, too. It didn't have the best ending, either, unfortunately. Not that there was much drama, it was just... there were some management decisions that I thought were fairly ironic and may have contributed to the collapse. It didn't help that one of the lead artists literally just decided to ghost the project entirely. The other issue was, and I didn't voice these concerns because, well, I don't think they would have done anything. I was concerned that one of the partners that we took in on the project maybe shouldn't have given the lead writer role to his friend. Part of the reason he did that is because I kind of was easily stressed out and I fucked up a few times when I was completing my sections, mainly doing things at the last minute, you know. But ironically, when push came to shove, I was the one who actually got his work done and submitted, even if it was last minute. And we were supposed to do it using the coding format, not written out like in a Word document. So that's part of the reason why it took so long. Otherwise, I could crank out the same amount of stuff within minutes. They gave the bulk of the work to a different writer who, was not only late with his submissions, but he ended up submitting them in Word document format, so they would have needed to be retranslated back into the coding format anyway, which created a lot of problems. Yeah, and that's true. I mean, yeah, that's part of the problem. I was concerned because, part of the reason I kept my mouth shut was, I used to run a small business myself, and, well, I learned the hard way that, as it turns out, running a business with your friends is a great way to lose those friends and to cause issues. You don't have the objectivity that you would normally have with just people that are hired on, you know? I didn't bring that up because I wasn't entirely sure, first off, how accurate that would be to this situation. He seemed pretty confident that this person who he tapped to do the writing, who was a close friend, would be able to do the work, but they just did not have the drive to do so. So, while I would have been late and doing things last minute, at least I got my work done. Which is fairly ironic, all things considered. Yeah, that's part of the problem. It's hard to keep a friend in line, or, like, to keep a friend responsible, I guess. You can't always just rely on the friend being like, well, if I don't do this stuff that I was asked to do, it's going to make me look like an idiot. Because we have a tendency to be more like, oh, I'm friends, therefore you're going to cut me some slack, right? I mean, the original people who ran that, ran Traveling Merchant are still in our Discord, you know? But I only ever seen one of them that's active at any one time, that's CXY, you know, and he's actually in the VTuber thread. Maybe one day, sure. Ain't that the truth? Don't mind me, I'm just looking through Danger U's Discord really quick. Not entirely sure why. I should probably create a Discord server at least so I can ping people when streams are starting, so I don't need to post them in Danger U. Indeed, we are. At least for the most part. Fortunately, I think I was fairly serious about going in hiatus this time. It would be for the best. I'm not going to talk about it in stream, but I'll probably DM you later about the reason for me heading off this time. I mean, it's not relating to, it's actually not really relating to the person, to the Discord I've been removed from. Even without them, it would have been regarding something a lot more serious that happened before that. Well, also, I just don't want to have it on record as having been discussed on stream. It's not important to anyone who would watch this in the future. It's rather personal. And I don't know. I just don't feel like it would be. I don't agree with. Well, yeah, not really. And also, I don't really agree with some entertainers that seek to talk about everything that's part of their life in these things. I mean, I understand there's some level of familiarity and, like, closeness that you might have with your audience and whatnot, but at the same time, I feel like we don't really need to know everything there is to know about the actor, and I feel like there is something to be said about keeping things to some mystique to yourself. I mean, at the end of the day, this is just kind of a mask I'm wearing, albeit one that I particularly enjoy, so. Hey Nufty, welcome to the stream. I'm just reading the cutscenes of the most recent Girls Friend Line event before the event ends in about an hour and a half from now. I mean, I guess it's fine to have something like a friend relationship with your viewers, but there has to be, you need a barrier, if not barrier, then boundaries need to be kept, I guess. Yeah, no kidding. Shoot, I forgot which one I did. Was it this one? Okay, it's this one. Which means it's probably this one next. This is not nearly as long as the previous ones, but it's still pretty long. Oh, that's true. You make an unfortunately true point. Yeah, some of these are really long, Iceland. Like, I mean, even the Girls Frontline was, the Valhalla one was, what, 6+ hours? Maybe even 8? It took a long time to read. Some of these are so... The Division one, the one that was a collab with the Division, was so long I couldn't even finish it before time ran out. I was only able to do the main plot. I couldn't read any of the side story, all of the side stories, because there are a lot of side stories for that one. I know, right? Danger brain material. Danger fit material too, I guess. Oh, so that's what this is. This is the... Okay. Continue. Aww. Wow, that's actually kind of serious. The writers of Girls Frontline these days have been actually very good about pacing. Extremely good, in fact. And what's funny is, this is a collab, and it's still decent, but they don't really hire the people from the collab itself to write the stories. They just do it themselves based on what they know about the universe. And since Yuzon's approach to doing collabs is to just do collabs with stuff he personally likes, he and the developers Mika are probably huge fans of this anime and manga series, which is why they're doing such a good job of writing it. They were major fans of Valhalla also, and that's why Valhalla's was so in-depth. To the point where they actually asked Ironic Lark to edit the script after they had done it, just to make sure that it was the characters were as they should be. Mm-hmm. Ten or so hot dogs. This is really adorable. Oh, shit. Beautiful. All right, that was chapter 7. Where is chapter 8? The final chapter, at last. Ha 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 You know what? I went to the official Discord to ask and no one answered. We don't, there doesn't seem to be an answer to that. Supposedly, Ironic Lark is working on the second Valhalla game again, or Nirvana. But they haven't officially said anything to that effect. I hope things are good too. Yeah, I agree. Aw, this is an adorable picture too. So control it less. I guess they can just teleport at will between these different worlds because it's magic and fuck. Explaining anything? It is pretty heavy anyway, so I don't mind so much. Oh yeah, even though they're dolls, they actually can eat food and drink. It supplements their power systems, although the majority of their energy comes from literally plugging themselves to wall outlets. But they do have biological systems. They're closer to synthetics than pure androids. So less like C-3PO and more like synthetics, I guess. The commander at this point just does not care. He's been through so much shit, or she. Well, what do you know? We made it. Huh? Uh-oh. Oh no, Piccolo is stuck in the... It's because they think she's a doll. Cool. Completed every single story. Completed every single event thingamajigger. Done every one of these. And these things take place in the alternate reality. You'd plug her in? You would. Just going through here and rereading these cutscenes too, since they're shorter. And then after that, I'm going to make some bad financial decisions and buy some costumes. And then we'll call it a night. I got about an hour left. This event ends in about an hour from now, at around 2 in the morning my time. Already, I think I already watched this actually. Let me see if there's. Oh. You're gonna tap out now too? Alright. Well, thanks for sticking with the stream and reading alongside all these cutscenes with me. You have a good night, Iceland. I'll actually be ending the stream fairly shortly too. Well, I've been streaming for 3 hours. So have I been streaming for like 4 or 5 hours consistently or now? Alright. Have a good night. See you later. Adios. Springfield. Guji, modotte maerimashita. Tadaima, shikikan. Tsugi no nimu, modorimashita. Subete junchou deshita yo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Need some, do some quick maths. Holy shit. Am I about to make a really bad financial decision? Things I do sometimes. Hey, soda fish. Well, that's not a good idea. Girl's front line is looking out for me. Welcome to the stream. Unfortunately, you kind of came in at the tail end. Yeah, man. It's basically saying, no, you will not spend money on gacha. Probably a good idea. I could use that money for something else. I'm sorry that you came in at literally the tail end of the stream. I'm going to go ahead and go to bed. Oh, well, thank you for the follow. I don't typically do our stream gacha games, to be honest. I just decided to do tonight because this event ends tonight. Oh, thanks. Hope to see you around in the next stream, and you have a good night as well. See you later!